I'd like to talk about something uncomfortable in the flashlight community. One of my knife video watchers is like, flashlight community? That already sounds uncomfortable. Hey, watch it. Flashlight usage for a good portion of people who buy them is confined to a white apartment wall to criticize tint and beam pattern. It's sort of kind of like how most knives are used for Instagram, pocket dump, everyday carry coordination instead of actual cutting things. Oh, I've never thought about using a Red Skull lanyard bead on my Marifone. It'll look great opening legal documents. Now, some lights have to be used outside to realize their full potential, like the Silent Thunder Ordnance Ultra Thrower, the Lance of Ra, not for use indoors. Now, if you follow me on Instagram, you'll know not only that I drink beer, but also I've had this light for quite some time, and people ask me about it. Even one person who tried to impersonate me to try to find out more information about it. But that's a different story. It took me a while to get footage, and Silent Thunder Ordnance is releasing a new light called the Storm of Ra, and this review will be timed around the release for that one. But let's look at the Lance closer. It's one of Silent Thunder Ordnance's earliest flashlight projects, based loosely around a production aspheric flashlight, the Unique Fire UF-1508. Now, the Lance basically shares that light's battery tube for its massive 3D printed aspheric head. You're like, oh, 3D printing, like my lower, what were we talking about again? Sorry. The head is comprised of a Night Piercer LED light engine, a glass optic, some additional heat sinking, and a custom driver. So let's look at the output estimates by me with some disclaimers. This light is literally one of the throwiest, or the throwiest lights ever made. Silent Thunder Ordnance measures the light at 21 meters and converts further ANSI readings. They put it on a tripod and they clamp it down and are pretty precise about it. Now you can measure at 25 or 35 feet, but it will read much lower in the throw on the turbo mode. I know, I've tried it. That and the beam pattern was so pencil thin, I was not able to get accurate lumens ratings, so I'm not going to publish what I tested. Silent Thunder said the emitter is rated at 800 theoretical lumens on turbo, so less than that. First is low. Doot, doot, doot. Then is mid. Doot, doot, doot. Then is high. Doot, doot, doot. Then is turbo. Remember, you have to test at 21 meters. If you don't, you're going to get a much lower reading, somewhere probably around 1.5 million candela. Test it at 21 meters and convert. Okay, how about that user interface? The Lance uses two 18650 batteries. I use two Samsung 30Q high drain batteries. Button tops. Flat tops may not work. Stick them positive end facing the lens. Screw on the tail cap. Press it once to turn it on. Half presses, scroll through all the modes from low, mid, high, turbo, low, mid, high, turbo, low, mid, high, turbo, low, mid, high. There is no mode memory. It always starts on low. A full click turns it off. Awesome. Now I won't attempt runtimes on this, mainly because Silent Thunder Ordnance says high is direct drive. So it's best to use it about 10 minutes at a time or less to manage heat properly or get someone to blow on it real hard. Okay, don't do that. Now, while other lights are production lights, this light needs to be treated like a modified light because, you know, that's what it is. Talk sweetly to it, give it a kiss at bedtime, you know, treat it like your custom knives. Okay, yeah, I get it. Okay, how about the beam shots? I will only be comparing a few lights here. A zooming aspheric, my biggest traditional thrower, and a flutter thrower combo in the Nikkor. All lights here are over 100,000 candela, or extremely long-range lights, with a variety of beam patterns. First up, let's look at the Lance at 100 feet. 100 feet is not a good distance to enjoy this light. It will illuminate things only a couple feet wide. If you're looking for something small at a short range, that's kind of weird, but we're on the internet, so sure. Now the other aspheric, the Brian AP-158. Remember that review? It's a larger area at full focus. It's more of a practical light for close and long range because it's a zooming light. You get full flood, full zoom. That's pretty cool. The Lance is not a zooming light. It is a fixed focal length. It is also not an everyday carry light. It's a light you build a wooden case for and take it out on an open prairie somewhere or to the desert. light you would use with binoculars or a spotting scope, and preferably over 1,000 feet. Now the Ace Beam K70, a more conventional light with a dense hotspot. This light has a more usable beam at close distances because of its dim spill. Back to the Lance, which has a spill at closer range, so you actually can see more than just the dot on the ground. It's a very dim spill, and it doesn't show up well on camera. And you won't see it at a distance of much more than 100 feet. Now the Nikkor TM16GT. This one has more spill than the rest. It's also the brightest light here. All right, let's move up to 800 feet. Okay, at 800 feet, some of these lights start to struggle. I know what the ANSI rating is in meters, but that's not real world usage. Not the Lance though. It still only has a few feet wide, off in the distance. It's sort of like a laser pointer of, you know, light. The Brynite B158 now, not as good at this distance. It's very dim, you know. You only want to use it a few hundred feet. Back to the Lance for a second. By the way, that Brynite B158 is modified. The standard Brynite is not that throwy. Okay, K70. It's still pretty good at this distance, even though it has a fraction of the candela of the Lance. And it's also my second throwiest light behind the Lance. The only other one that I know of offhand in between would be the Thrunite TN42, and I don't own that. Now the Nikkor TM16GT. Now at this distance, the Nikkor winds up scattering a lot of light. All right, now an extreme throw test, only with my K70 and the Lance on the beach. It was extremely hard for me to find a large open area where the light could be appreciated. That's why this review took so long, because I had to wait till I found something that I could shine on at a long distance. Staring down the beach, the Lance looks like just a beam of focused light. The trees are hard to see, so, you know, because they're dark and it's dark, and I don't exactly know how far some of those are. Now the K70. See how much spill the light has comparatively? It shows just how much more efficient that large head and the lens is on the Lance at focusing the light. Okay, so earlier you noticed there's a building. Maybe. There's actually a lot of light in the distance. It's about 2,800 feet away according to Google Earth. So with my wide-angle lens, it looks like a little dot of light, a little few dots. So let's swap on my 50mm lens, which is more like a 144mm lens, when you factor in the crop factor on my Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera. Okay, see how well it does? The K70 wasn't really photographable at this distance, so I didn't do it. So this is, again, about a 2.5 million candela light. Think about that for a second. And the closest current production light is the TN42 from Thrunite, like I said earlier, at 600,000 candela. Now, I'm sure that'll change in a few months with the new budget light form special edition super ultra thrower. Still won't be as throwy as this light, but if you want the throwiest light, this is it. The Lance of Ra has the most specific purpose of any light I've ever tested. It is not for everyone. It's for people who need very long range lights. And it's best used in conjunction with a spotting scope or binoculars, because you will not see something several thousand feet away clearly with your naked eye. I can't, you can't either. Atmospheric conditions like rain, humidity, fog, and sitting in your apartment might affect how far the beam can travel. So it's best used in drier climates and conditions. If you like this review and would like to know more technical questions than I can answer, check out Silent Thunder Ordnance's website and shoot them an email. Look out for my review of the Big Lumen 700,000 candela-ish compound optic light coming from Silent Thunder Ordnance called The Storm. It's every bit as unique as this one and is totally an original design with all sorts of bespoke options. Like, subscribe, comment, give this video a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.